Hello students of standard 7th, welcome to TAV Mall Public School. I am your English teacher Jagruti Mishra. Let's begin our today's online session of English. Dear students, today we will continue with the same chapter from your English literature, Chocolate in Your Dreams 2. As we have already seen in Act 1 and 2 that Gopa's mother Mrs. Dev is very much concerned about Gopa's physical health. Gopa eats too many chocolates, not do any physical exercise. He keeps on watching TV for hours. And when his mother is insisting him to go out for playing, and he goes out for playing, but there also he plays video games with his friends. Now let's see what happens in Act 3. It's the scene of Gopa's bedroom. Photos of music and sport celebrities adorn the wall. A bookcase, a table with a table lamp, and books and a chair are seen in the room. A few shirts and trousers are hung on hooks on the wall. Gopa in a nightdress is lying in his bed. And he is fast asleep. Suddenly, Gopa opened his eyes on hearing a sound. "Hey Roma, is that you?" "Alien," voice from background. "No, no, it's not Roma, it's me." Gopa then looks around. "It's me? Who's that?" "Alien," again a voice from background. "It's me here." Gopa again looks around. Where? "Alien," voice again from background. "In your shirt pocket." Gopa, "Wow, in my shirt pocket?" So he looks cautiously inside the pocket of his nightshirt. "Alien," again from voice from background. "Oh, not inside your nightshirt pocket, inside your shirt pocket, my dear." Gopa again looks around. "Where's my shirt pocket?" Alien then again speaks, a voice from background. "Your shirt is hanging on the wall." Dear students, are you knowing what is an alien? An alien is a creature from different planet. Gopa, "Oh, I see," and he jumps out of bed, runs to his shirt, put his hand into it and picks up a small statue like thing and holds it up in the dim light. "Wow, when did this thing get into my shirt pocket?" And places it on the table as he tries to find out what it is. Alien. A sudden darkness on the stage appears. When the lights come, the statue has turned into an alien, being the size of a boy. "Here I am in normal size." As I told you, an alien is a creature from different planet. Gopa, after seeing that alien, says, "Wow, such a big boy," and scared as he looks at the alien. "Alien, I am not a big boy, I am an alien." Gopa then asks, "Alien, is that your name?" To this alien replies, "Well, my name is unpronounceable by Earth standards, but because I am an alien to your world, I call myself Alien. You can also call me Alien." Gopa then says, "Oh, is it? How did you get into my pocket?" Then Alien replies, "That's very easy. But I won't tell you the trick. That's our own secret. We regularly get into the pockets of human beings. That's how we study human beings and their world." Gopa, "Have you come here to study our world and us?" To this, Alien replies, "Yes, we have Been doing that for quite some time now. Gopa, what do you mean? Alien replies, yes, you have heard it right. Gopa then says, which means you have a purpose in studying us and our world. To this, alien replies, yes, there is. Gopa then asks, what is it? Alien, to watch you and your acts. Gopa, what are you likely to get out of it? Alien then answers, do you have the courage to listen to what I have to say? Gopa then says, what is it you likely to tell me which needs courage to listen? Now alien says, tell me, do you have the courage or not? Say yes or no. He is actually threatening Gopa and asking, are you having courage to listen or not? Gopa then says, yes, I have courage. To this, alien says, okay, then get ready and listen carefully. Gopa says, fine, I am ready. Let's see what alien wants to say about Gopa in our next session. Here we end our today's session. Have a nice day. Thank you.